Question 37. This is a consumer arithmetic question. See if you can do this in a minute and a half and come back. All right. During a sale, a discount of 15% was given off the marked price of a chair. Okay. If the marked price was 115, then the sale price was, all right, what comes off the price? It's 15 per, which is divide, cent, which is 100. So it's 15 per 100, 15 out of 100, off, which is multiply, $115. That's what comes off. So, let's see. 5 into 15 goes 3 times. 5 into 10, 2 and 0. So 5 into 120. 5 into 20 is 4. 5 into 115. 5 into 10 is 2. The remainder 1. 5 into 15, 3. So, it's 3 threes. 9, 3, 2, 6. That's 69 over 4. That comes off the marked price. So let's see what this says. 4 into 4, 1. 4 into 6 goes 1 time, remainder 2. 4 into 29, 4 into 7, 28 is 7, remainder 1. 7 and a quarter is 0.25. Now a number minus 0.25 leaves 0.75. That's indicating what the answer is so far. But anyway, if we say 115 minus 17.25, first of all, what is 115 minus 17? If you take 15, 115 minus 15 minus, you need two more. 2.75. You drop 115 from 100, you get 100. If you drop 115 from 115, if you drop 15 from 115, you get 100, and then a little more, you drop a little below 100, showing that it is this. Alright, so that is indicating the answer A already. Let's see another way you could figure this out. Here, you cannot drop the price by 115. In other words, discount the price by 115 and it goes up. So, the ridiculous answers here you can eliminate quickly is 132, which is a larger price, and 130, also a bigger price. It cannot go up, it has to drop. Now, how much does it drop? If you save $15 off, it goes to 100. But then, 15% of this is not $15. It's a little more than $15. 15% of 100 is 15. But 15% of 115 must be larger than 15. So it would drop below 100, indicating this. So you didn't really have to do any calculation to get the answer, all right? Or you could do a little mental calculation to get the answer. So everything is pointing to A as the answer for question 37.